My name is Kerstin Timm.
I am a British Heart Foundation funded research fellow at the University of Oxford, and I work in the Department of Physiology, Anatomy and Genetics under Professor Damien Tyler.
My name is Philippa Coffey. I'm 53 and I'm from Sheffield.
A lot of patients that receive chemotherapy might survive their initial cancer, especially breast cancer patients as well as children with leukemia. But unfortunately, a small subset of those patients will later on develop heart failure. I used to work on cancer models and I wanted to transition into cardiac research,
which is hyperpolarized magnetic resonance imaging. So this research is trying to firstly find out why there is a toxicity to the heart and also to try and detect this early so there is a chance that they do not have to suffer from ill effects caused by the chemotherapy.
In June 2015, I was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma stage 4. The last chemotherapy I had was December 2015. By January, I was told, thankfully, I was in remission. And from then on, I expected to start feeling better. Mm. But I didn't, and was told, you've got heart failure.
So the idea with the MRI scans that I do preclinically at the moment is that potentially we could see changes to the heart happen before you feel the breathlessness, before there actually is changes to the function of the heart.
What stage are you at the moment? Are we getting to the clinical trial stage?
No, at the moment it's all purely preclinical. The good thing here at Oxford is though that the professor under which I'm working, Damien Tyler, has the clinical setup ready to go. But obviously we have to have enough evidence to move into clinical trials. Meeting you today is really great for me because as I work in a preclinical setting, it's easy to get carried away with lab experiments and everything, and it's really nice to see that there is people that really, really would benefit from this, and it really motivates me to push forward.
Lovely to see all the work she's doing, how that clinicians in the future will interpret the information and put it to good use, hopefully, to prevent other patients ending up with heart failure as I've done.